It's news time. Information is power. Be current. The news headline. Canadian minister tackles Buhari. Says he has taken Nigeria to a dangerous territory. The Minister of Justice and Solicitor General of the Canadian government of Alberta, Kelechi Madu, says he has forward to the emergence of a competent and visionary leader as Nigeria has drifted into dangerous territory under President Muhammadu Buhari regime. While no one doubts that the country has drifted into dangerous territory, Mr. Madu said in a statement shared on his Facebook page on Friday to mark Nigeria's Independence Day celebration. I have always been an eternal optimist about the future of the ordinary people of Nigeria, he said. Mr. Madu described Nigeria as a sleeping giant with huge human and natural resources, saying he looks forward to the emergence of a competent and visionary leader. I look forward to a new and reimagined leadership with a vision, capacity and good intentions to think through the entire country from the rainforest of the southeast to the cocoa plantation of the southwest, the mountains of plateau and desert plains of the north, he said. The people of this sleeping giant are exceedingly blessed with human and natural resources. They are hardworking, bright and resilient. I am rooting for their liberation and success so that they can achieve their God-given potential. I wish them a happy celebration, Mr. Madu said. Nigeria marked our 61st independence anniversary on Friday, eliciting much criticism over insecurity, underdevelopment, and economic hardship. Contrary to criticisms, Mr. Buhari in a speech said he had done better than his predecessor since Nigeria returned to democratic rule in 1999. And here is the Minister of Justice and Solicitor General of the Canadian government telling Buhari that Nigeria has actually drifted into dangerous territory under him, and saying that there is no doubt that the country is seriously in chaos, and that it seems that there is hopelessness around the country because the citizens are actually have actually lost the faith and competence in the Buhari-led administration, saying that it is therefore needed to reimagine the leadership with vision and capacity and good intentions to think that the entire country from the south and the west, the mountains of plateau and everywhere, because the sleeping giant, like Nigeria is called the giant, is extremely blessed with natural resources, but insecurity, underdevelopment and economic hardship had become the order of the day. And this is why the agitators had actually been clamoring for self-determination and a country of their own, because Nigeria designed to hold down the progress and development of the ethnic nationalities in the forceful marriage of inconvenience. And this is a failed state that should be peacefully dissolved now to avoid a senseless ongoing pogrom before it blossoms into a protracted civil war. In the last 107 years of this forceful merger, we, the Yoruba, have done everything humanly possible to make the lopsided federal union work with justice, fairness, equity and unity as the watchword. But to our chagrin, the most backward section of Nigeria ruling class, the Fulani aristocracy, which the British gave the baton of leadership, see other ethnic nationalities as their vassal states. The 61 years of independence is a catalogue of woes for the Nigerian people. This was compounded by Buhari nepotism, whose kith and kins the Fulani mimed, raped, kidnapped for ransom, and forcefully occupied others' ancestral land with impunity. The complicity of the Buhari presidency informed the renewed vigor for Yoruba quest for a liberated Oodua nation. While the Fulani government of Nigeria, which is the Buhari dictatorship, had reduced governance to dictatorship,
Opposition's politicians are blackmailed, harassed by the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission, ESCC, and armed, twisted to join the ruling APC. Irrepressible opposition, like Omoyere Sowore's movement, is restricted to Abuja. Nnamdi Kanu, leader of separatist IPOB, was abducted Gestapo-like in Kenya and clamped into the detention. Sunday Igbowo, a Yoruba determination activist who escaped assassination by the Wiska, is detained at Benin Republic. The unrelenting Buhari dictatorship is wasting millions of dollars in bribery for Igbowo to be extradited to Nigeria. At the time, killer Fulani herdsmen were rehabilitated and paid fat salary, with Boko Haram members reintegrated into the Nigerian army. The group stated that it wants a national referendum that will dissolve the Nigerian state, which the world governing body, United Nations, should oversee. The Yoruba, the Youth Revolutionary Movement, also reiterated that Yoruba people are not interested in the next general elections in 2023, but in self-determination to bring about a sovereign Yoruba nation. We of the Yoruba Revolutionary Movement, YOREM, which to state for the umpteenth time that our agitation as a people is very clear. We want a United Nations supervised national referendum for the peaceful dissolution of the Nigerian state to avoid unprecedented genocide in the field British contraption. And these were the analysis and words by the Yoruba revolutionary movement, who are saying that they are not interested in the next general elections for 2023 and that they want a self-determination, requesting that the United Nations should actually come and supervise a national referendum for the peaceful dissolution of the Nigerian state, saying that they want to break up from Nigeria because the President Muhammadu Buhari's government is haunting and haunting its opposition, who are telling the administration the truth of being like the, that they should be fair, they should be standard with their equity and justice, and not to treat people with disdain, and therefore saying that anytime anyone seems to be against what the government is doing, which is actually affecting the Nigerian population, that what the government does is to make sure that they forcefully silence them or try to kill them, and that the Buhari-led APC government is full of nepotism and tyranny, because Nigeria designed to hold down the progress and development of the different ethnic nationalities in a forceful marriage of inconvenience. That is, the Buhari-led administration doesn't want people to go, the ethnic groups to go on separate ways, yet inconveniencing them because nothing is blossoming and favoring the ethnic people diverse in the country. Therefore, they are claiming that the 61 years of the independence is a catalogue of woes for the Nigerian people, because the Fulani people